Just let everybody sit down first.
Goodman's release change anything?
No, I was just going to make a statement on that. All of us here are delighted, of course, and very happy that this has taken place. I have been in touch with and talking with Reverend Jackson, with our ambassador there, and with Lieutenant Goodman, who is, of course, pleased that he is coming home. And we, as I say, are very pleased with this. And now, Ambassador Rumsfeld will be leaving this evening for Lebanon, and we will, with renewed spirit, continue our efforts and our negotiations to advance the cause of peace in Lebanon.
Do you think this is a peace gesture on the part of the Syrian government?
I'm not going to place any interpretation on it. I just am pleased that this action was taken.
How does Goodman sound to you, sir?
Just fine. But then I expected that. The conversation I had with his wife earlier while he was still a prisoner, and to keep her up to date in our own efforts of trying to bring about his release. She told me a little about her husband, and it was that she had great faith in his ability to meet the circumstances there, what he was undergoing, and it evidently is true. He's a fine man.
Did Reverend Jackson do a good job?
Chorus.
You don't quarrel with success.
Are you going to see the
yes.
Reverend?
What?
Are you going to see the Reverend Jackson tomorrow?
Yes, yes, I'm looking forward to it.
Here?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Mr. President, we are celebrating the year. We may begin the meeting with the
The Lord, we praise you and we exalt you. We recognize you in our presence and in our midst. And you have said, order my steps and my work, and let not any iniquity have dominion over me. This advice you've given to each of us. We choose in this county council and its deliberations to order our steps in thy wisdom. And we ask you to share your inspiration with us, with our president and with each of us in our deliberations. We praise you, Lord. We bless you. In Jesus' name, amen. Well,
prayers
the Lord will take care of it, all the rest of it. But
prayers are answered. Jesse Jackson bringing Lieutenant Goodman home today.
I know. Would he be as interested if Lieutenant Goodman were a woman? We don't know. However, Mr. President, today at our county council, we have an interesting agenda. I wish to say that at the outset, in terms of the liver transplant.
Isn't that crap in the middle of all of it? Now he's back at his house and he says, I really got to have that drink. And he starts, and there's a knock at the door. And he goes to the door, and there's an angel with a Christmas tree. And she said, what do you want me to do with this? And he told her.
Mr. President, Don Leslie with the National Association of Wheat Growers. Happy New Year to you.
Thank you.
Mr. President, Don Zimmerman, President of the National Sunflower Association.
Okay, I'm going to do that.
Right. Well, there, so you won't forget it.
She's not nice. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Appreciate your time, and you've done a great job. We're all very proud. We're going to work hard for you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much. I deserve it.
Day in history of Wall Street.
Wow.
50 million shares changed hands, and they are still coming. So I don't know what the total will be. I don't know what it will close at. It's up about 10 points at the time that I heard this.
Gee, a good day is about, what, 70 million?
Huh?
A good day is about 70 million?
Yeah, although they've had 100 million days.
Yeah.
But this is the all-time record. And the legend or the tradition in Wall Street is that what happens in the first week of the new year decides what will happen in the first month, and that decides what the year will be.
Yeah.
So let's not break any traditions. This is Mary.
Hello. It's a pleasure to meet you. I can't say how excited I am.
Well, what's your
name? You want to use my shirt?
I think they'll.
You want some pictures? My daughter ended up in the hospital.
Oh.
She sees you on TV all the time, so she was very impressed that I was coming. And she said, are you going to be on TV with the president, Mom?
Yes, yes, yes. Well, is she permitted candy?
Yes.
Have we got it?
Oh,
okay. You got a little something to take care of.
Oh, okay. I understand you've been meeting a lot of people, so I'm like,
that's right, yeah.
I'm from Tennessee. I understand that you've visited there a few times.
Oh, yes.
It's just such a joy. I couldn't say it myself.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, don't worry.
We're having a problem, Mr. President. It will be just better.
Oh, I don't. Yeah.
We'll give it to her.
Oh, all right. This is a souvenir. This is a presidential crest. What we sent for, we have some jars, nice little jars that have the crest on them.
I was wondering about the jelly.
Yes, yes.
Oh, well, I will just.
So they say they'll get it. It's way over here.
Okay.
Well, it's a pleasure to see you. And I know they keep you rather busy with this title, too.
Yeah, I have been quite busy, although I got to go home for Christmas for about 3 weeks, and that was really nice. But we got back from the Rose Bowl. I was in the tournament of Rose Bowl. My husband and I got to the.
Well, I was on a plane. I didn't get to see the parade.
Oh, I enjoy it, but you've commentated for it.
Oh, yes.
Years ago.
I used to work as a guest shot on TV, and I, for 7 years, yeah, I broadcast the parade.
Yeah, it was a parade. Fantastic. Good.
So you probably, to be in the parade, had maybe some of the same experience, would have to get up before dawn.
Mm-hmm.
And one year, because they close all traffic other than the parade traffic, and 1 year, the only way we got to the place where I was to broadcast was they hired an ambulance.
Ambulance, I heard that story.
Yeah, an ambulance.
And we got you there.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, great pleasure.
Please give my best and warmest regards to Mrs. Reagan.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you. There's the door. April will be delighted. I wonder if she'll share this with me. Thank you. Let me give you a kiss, too. This is from the 51 million married women in across America.
No, thank you very much. You see, that's why you get a job.